Hi guys. So yeah, in order to configure your Google conversion tag, first is you need to go to the tools and settings, and then go to the conversions under measurement. Now you can create. He already created. My client already created a conversion action here, but I'll just give you like a quick walkthrough how that works. So. So this conversion action sets is used. Let's say if you want to organize all of your conversion actions, then you can use a conversion action sets. Let's say, for example, you want to organize all of your booking conversion actions, and you call it booking. So just simply select what kind of conversion you want them to include into your action sets, and then just click the save one. Let's go back to the conversion actions and let's configure this one. So basically, let me give you like a quick through how he did this one. So basically, you just need to click this plus conversion, and then you select what kind of conversion you want. And normally, you want to purchase. What is the category? So at the moment, we want to select this part, this book online. So select book appointment and name of the conversion, and then value. So how much is the value for per conversion? So yeah, let's say for example $20, and then this part, like at every conversion, when do you want it to be triggered? So I will create another conversion here because the conversion action he did is, I think, wrong. So I'm gonna create a book an appointment with thank you page because the conversion action that he did doesn't have a thank you page. I'll just let him know later. So 20, and then I want that every count, every conversion, I mean every successful sign up on this page will count. So that is basically that it means if someone clicks your ad and completes in two separate purchases on different occasions, there will be two conversion recorded. But if you wanted one, then there's only one conversion, even though he did two events at the same time, so it only converted once. But I want it to be every conversion. Now, click through conversion window, I want it to be the basic, the default 30 days, and let's just skip this by default and then create continue. Now, this part, the Google Tag Manager. We can, if you want to put the Google, if you want to use the traditional way, you just need to click this install thing. And then first is you need, if you haven't, you need to install this gtag.js if you haven't installed the global gtag. So this is the most problem why their conversion tag is not triggering because you did not install your Google site tag. So you can install this into your head section. So I am running a Divi website, so you can just go to the Divi theme options and then go to the integration and put it here. Okay, so the global tag manager has the same tags in all of your conversion actions. So this is only a one-time setup, so you need to install your global tags. And then let's say you don't want to use Google Tag Manager. You felt that it is so, it's so jargon for you. Now you can select this snippet. So let's say you just want to track the page load. So if someone visits to this book online page, then I want to track the page load. If you want to select a certain a clicks like a button, then you need to use this, but we will not cover this one. Let me know if you want me to do a tutorial about click events. I would love to do so, but let's just do the page load here. So if you want to use the page load, you can click this one, select, and then go to the page itself, and then you need to put the code in the body section. So in every, I mean, it does, it's not necessary that you use Divi, but you just need to put it into an HTML format and put the script here. So that is how it works. Now, the problem in here on his website, because basically this page load should be in the thank you page conversion, but on his this booking form, I don't have control in this booking form, and he preferred to use this Sunix computer consultant, something like this, and I don't have control in that. So if I book on his form, let's say this one, okay, I'm gonna, let's say for example this one, and then I put like an information about myself, and let's say info blah blah blah, and I put it like this, and then put some information, and then I submit it, just sent a confirmation message that your appointment has been booked. So I emailed the developer, because I don't have access in this iframe, I emailed the developer if it's possible for us to redirect this into thank you page. So this is the thank you page that I told to him to be redirected. So let's create a thank you page for that. I'm going to delete this one. Okay, so basically you need to put this conversion into the thank you page. I'll go back to the thank you, because that's the basic, right? If you submit to a form, you will be redirected to a thank you page. But at the moment, our calendar or our booking form doesn't have a thank you page. So just giving you like, okay, thank you for booking. And then I will add a script here, and I'm gonna name that one thank you and booking, and then publish. So that should be the right thing. So you need to have a confirmation page, a booking page, and then a thank you page. So let's make our thank you page a bit cleaner. I just wanted to make it full width. So yeah, so code, okay, and then thank you. So you need to put that into your thank you page. Okay, this part, the page on load. But right now, as I said, we don't have a thank you page yet. So temporarily, I can put the conversion into this page. But the problem is, the conversion will be triggered every time someone visit the book online, which we don't want that to make happen, because not all the visitors who comes to the book online will book a consultation with him. So that's what I'm trying to say with him, that we need to have a thank you page. But yeah, that's how it goes. You just need to make sure you put this global site tag into your head section, and then this page load, you put it on your thank you page. And if it's an on click, you want to set up the trigger by clicks, then you can select this click. Okay, so that's how it works. And right now it is still, I believe it is still unverified. So it is still unverified here, because it is still unverified because it takes a bit like 3 hours to get verified. So here, now this one is, okay, now this one is the conversion action that he did, and I already configured this one. So if I click this part, and let's say that we will use a Google Tag Manager instead of a tag, the traditional way, you just need to click this Use Google Tag Manager. And again, even though you use Google Tag Manager, you still need to have this code. Again, this will only configure once you already put your global G tag. You should be good to go. So you just need to put that tag at once into your head section. You don't need to be like repeat it all the time. So just configure it once. And then in the Google Tag Manager, let's say, what is a Google Tag Manager? Google Tag Manager is your organizer. So you can organize all of your tracking tools like Analytics, FB Pixels, LinkedIn Pixels, and all of those scripts. So I highly recommend that you familiarize Google Tag Manager to make all of your tracking tools at once. You don't need to log in different pages, in different sites. So to do that, go to the Google Tag Manager. Just search in Google, and you should be able to see this tagmanager.com, that google.com. And then you will ask to create an account, and you will be redirected here. So just click the create account, and then put your name, and then what country you are, and then your website, and then click this web, and then hit the create. And then once you're ready, hit that create thing. You will have this. Okay, I'm sorry. So let's go back here. You should able to have this container thing here. So the iBase has already a Google Tag Manager, so we will not create that a new one. So I just need to click this create this iBase. And then after you have a Google Tag Manager, click the admin section and then go to the install Google Tag Manager. Make sure that this Google Tag Manager part is installed in your head section. This is it. And then the other one, this part should be installed in the body section. Okay, you need to put the two codes together. You need to put it in the head section, and the other one you need to put on the body section. Otherwise, if you miss installing all these two codes, your Google Tag Manager will not work. Okay, now we already have the Google Tag Manager script, and we already have the global thing. Now, to check if our Google Tag Manager is working, you can install a Google Tag Manager extension and then click this Tag Assistant. Okay, you can install this one. This is free and you should be able to see this. Okay, now let's go back to the booking part here. Now, if you click this one, okay, and enable it, okay, let's record. Wait, it's not working. Let me take a look. Hold on. So, refreshed, and I will click this one. You will see that the Google Tag Manager is working in here. Now, I already configured the conversion tag in this part, but basically, again, I will need to change this one because I don't want to trigger the conversion tag into a book online. I want to filter those visitors who only book. Not just, I mean, not all the visitors comes from the book online will book this form. So again, just giving you like a quick heads up how you can configure your Google Tag Manager. So go back to the Google Tag Manager.com, and then okay, I'm sorry, Google Tag Manager. Okay, Google Tag Manager, and then you need to create, okay, let's select the IBs first. Now you need to create a trigger. So click the triggers, and then I will, as you can see here, I already configured something here, like booking. So in order to create a booking, a trigger, you can click like new and then name the trigger, and then what trigger you want to happen. So in this case, we just want to target the book online page. But again, the right thing is I need to put that in a thank you page rather than into the book online page. But my task is he want this part to work. So I'm just doing my job, even though it's not right. But I already told him that we need to create a thank you page instead of just directly tracking all the visitors. So yeah, again, you need to you can click page view, and then like what we need to isolate the page. So we only want to track the book online, and then you can select the page URL that contains this one. Okay, and then just click the save one. So I don't want to save that because we already have this. So if I go to the booking, the configuration are the same. Okay. Now, once you already have the trigger, you can go to the tags option. So, in the tags option, you need to create a, okay, in this part, like if this one, okay, before you configure your conversion ID and all of your label, you need to enable your conversion linker tag first. So, I already have that. So conversion linker tag, you can see here, conversion linker tag. And if you don't have yet, just click the new and then look for, you can call it conversion linker tag or whatever you want. And then go to the conversion and then you search for conversion linker, this one. And then, okay, link across domains. You don't have a lot of domains, so let's just keep it this as is. Override cookie if you are in e-commerce, so you will need to use this one. So, let's just keep that by default and triggering. So we want it to trigger in all of the pages, because this is a required thing to make to trigger our tracking. So conversion linker tag. So once again, we will not save this one because I already have a conversion linker tag. So let's just skip that, disregard. Now, once you already have a conversion linker tag, you can now start adding a AdWords conversion. Now, I have I created a booking conversion tag here already. As you can see here, okay, let's go back. It's already firing, but I'll just give you like a quick snip, quick heads up how that works. So you just need to go, let's go back to the conversion tag, and then you need to click the new, and then what's the name of your conversion tag? So this is a booking conversion, okay? And then the tag conversion, let's call that conversion, Google Ads conversion tracking. And then what's the conversion ID? So you go back to your Google AdWords, okay, this one. And then go to the use Google Tag Manager and you put your conversion ID, and then you put your conversion label, okay, and then the value, like how much is the value. But this one I'll keep it as empty, because again, this is not a thank you page, so I'm just doing my job. I just make it work, because this one is not working lately. It's just unverified. So I did my job, and then I asked a suggestion that instead of using the book online, you need to have a thank you page. So yeah, you need to fill in your value here. And then the triggering is you need to choose the trigger that you create, which is the booking trigger, and then click the save. Okay. And again, we will not do that, and then just disregard the changes. But basically, that's how it works. For the tags, you need to have a conversion linker, and you need to have a conversion tag manager. And for the trigger, you need to trigger a specific page. Okay, this part we trigger the book online. Okay, now after you do everything, I mean all the configuration, it will not update in real time. You need to click the submit. And then you can put any description, let's say V5, this changes, it's all about conversion for booking. So you just need that one, then click the publish one, okay? And then click this one. Now, if you want, if you want to see if it's ready, if it is really working, you can click the preview option, okay? You can click the preview option, and then enable the debug mode. So if you click the preview version, you will enable this debug mode. So if I click the refresh and then I go to the book online part, okay, book online part, if you enable the debug mode, you can see this part, okay? So as you can see here, the conversion, when I refresh this one, okay, and I refresh this one, and I see that the booking conversion tag that I've configured is already firing, and the conversion linker that we created is already firing. So it means that our conversion tag is working. If it's not working, it should fall in the tags not fired. So when you go back to your conversion area in the Google Tag Manager, the verification will not reflect in real time. So this one doesn't reflect in real time. You need to wait like 3 hours. Yeah, as you can see here, you haven't verified your tag yet. Usually it takes 3 hours to reflect. So, but normally it might take an hour to reflect that one. So that's how it works. Let me know if you have questions with Google Tag conversion tracking tools. I would love to answer your question. Just comment down below. And also, if you love to see more videos related to AdWords, just leave me a comment. Leave me a comment below, and I might consider creating another tutorial for Google AdWords. Thank you.